How's it going, Slasher fans? My name is Sean, and welcome to the channel's first ever Slasher Flick. Today we're going to be discussing Terrifier 2, where we got some leaked footage that I'm going to show you guys, as well as a possibility of new footage being released this weekend. We got a huge Texas Chainsaw Massacre update that we got to discuss, as well as some new details surrounding the Jeepers Creeper 4 movie, which is, thank God, being taken over from this old director, Vic DiSalvio. Fuck that motherfucker. And we also got our first reviews out for this new Halloween Kills movie, and it's not being received well by critics. That's what we're going to be talking about here today on...
What's your favorite scary movie? I told you not to hang up on me.
So the first thing I want to discuss here is we just got our first reviews back for this new Halloween Kills film, and it is not being received well by critics, but hey, that does not mean this movie is going to be bad, and I'm going to explain to you guys here why. So if you guys didn't know, there was basically this film festival being held in Venice, I think it was yesterday. One thing to keep in mind is this film festival is directed at more serious movies, so there was a lot more serious critics at this movie festival, and for some reason the directors of this movie thought that it would be a smart idea to play a slasher film at this more serious film festival. As we all know, critics do not usually like horror movies. They like to dog on horror movies a lot, and that is exactly what happened with Halloween Kills here. About 50% of the critics liked this movie, while the other 50% did not like this movie. So I'm going to read the reviews for you guys here in a second, but I just want to let you guys know, never take what a critic says, because critics go very harsh and deep into movies, and they like to critique their stuff, and they really like to give directors and stuff a hard time, especially horror directors. So I wouldn't take anything that you hear from these critics I'd take it lighthearted, just because like they don't really know nothing when it comes to horror films. None of them ever like horror films. So anyways, here's what the review said. One of the reviews said, Halloween Kills certainly feels like more Halloween. Okay, so it feels like the first Halloween film. I honestly think that's awesome. Continuing, he said, but the game board is left exactly as it was found in the readiness for round 13. The only thing that advances is the body count. Okay, so it feels very nostalgic to the first Halloween film, and obviously they're upping the body count. That sounds freaking great so far, man. Anyways, continuing, he said, it all feels so rote and old school. It feels old school. I don't see any issues with this review, especially during such an exciting era for the horror community. See, this just doesn't make sense to me. This dude is like trying to dog on the movie with his review, but his review doesn't make the movie sound bad. It honestly makes me excited. So this new Halloween Kills film ups the body count. There's gonna be a lot more kills in this movie. Fantastic. Fan-fucking-tastic. All right, next thing he says, it feels very nostalgic to the first Halloween film. Okay. That's fucking great. That's great. And it feels old school, so it feels a lot like older horror. I don't have a problem with that. I think that is a great review. Honestly, I wouldn't look at this review very harshly. I would look at it, just be lighthearted about it, because that does not mean this movie is going to be bad. I don't know what the directors were thinking again when they released this film to a film festival where they were playing a lot more serious films and they had a lot more stuck-up critics at this film. It's probably not your best bet to release the movie at a more serious film festival. I don't think slashers ever get released at these big film festivals, so, I mean, maybe they're trying something new here, but it obviously didn't go well. I mean, I personally thought that Jigsaw was a really good prequel, and it got so many bad reviews. So many bad reviews. And some horror fans may think that it's bad. I'm not really big into the Saw community, so I don't know what people think about it. I personally thought it was a pretty good prequel. I did not even expect a twist at the end of the movie. So I don't know what people are thinking about that movie. Feel free to let me know your thoughts and comments and theories down below. We also got a fairly big update on this new Jeepers Creepers 4 movie, which is officially being titled Jeepers Creepers Reborn. Now, if you guys aren't aware of the past history with this original director of the original trilogy, I don't want to get into it, but you always got Google if you guys want to go and do the research yourself. But they finally got a new director, thank fuck, so now I can actually talk about this movie. I wasn't ever comfortable talking about Jeepers Creepers just because of the history of the director, but now they got a new director and a new screenwriter. I'm more than happy to talk about it. I cannot pronounce his name, but this is how he looks. I'm gonna throw a picture up on screen, and I'm gonna basically go into everything that we do know about this movie for people who don't know much about it, because I know there's very few horror creators that are actually talking about this movie. And then we're gonna talk about some of the new information we have about this movie. So basically, the premise of Jeepers Creepers, Jeepers Creepers Reborn, it involves attendees of a fake festival called the Horror Hound Festival. This is basically a horror event, and it will have its first ever meeting in Louisiana. Unluckily though for the attendees, the creeper will be stalking and killing those in attending the festival nearby. Now, Jeepers Creepers Reborn will mainly focus on Chase and his girlfriend Lane. Chase is basically this horror fanboy, and Lane will be dragged along for the ride because, of course, that's his girlfriend. But Lane will be the one that starts to connect with Creeper, and she's also going to start to have premonitions and visions of Creeper and the town's past. Now, Lane will likely be the final girl of the movie and probably be the only one who may stop Creeper, at least until this next movie. Jeepers Creepers Reborn features a different director and screenwriter from the previous films. Victor Salva directed the first three films in the Jeepers Creepers series, and this kept the series shrouded in controversy because in 1988, I'm just going to say it, fuck it, Salva was convicted and sent to prison for sexually abusing a minor, and it appears that Salva has finally decided to step away from Jeepers Creepers. Yeah, that's right, get the hell away from it. And he could have been asked to, to be honest. And he will not be directing Jeepers Creepers Reborn, and he's also not attached as a producer, which I'm completely fine as. Now, the director's name, I cannot say it, but it's like Timo Versalo. I'm not even going to try to butcher it. He's directed Jeepers Creepers Reborn. His previous work includes the Star Trek films and the Iron Sky movies. Victor Salva also wrote the previous three films, and Shawn Michael, another Shawn, Argo, wrote the script for Jeepers Creepers Reborn. He's been known for writing fantasy book series, especially the Neurospace novels, if you guys have heard of that. I used to read quite a bit. Jeepers Creepers Reborn also kicks off a new trilogy, because with a new director and screenwriter, apparently comes a new trilogy. The Verity article that I was reading on before making this video mentions that Jeepers Creepers Reborn is the first in a planned trilogy, so they do have a trilogy planned out for this. And Verity didn't go into further details, but I'm going to suspect that if the contracts and schedules work out, the plan is probably to continue the other two films with the team that made Jeepers Creepers Reborn. Whether or not these future films happen probably depends on the reception and the box office numbers for this Jeepers Creepers 4 film. Now, another thing to mention is Jeepers Creepers Reborn wrapped up filming in 2021. So according to the same Verity article that I was reading, Jeepers Creepers Reborn began filming in December of 2020 and it finished up in January of 2021. This means the film was filmed, edited, and is planned to be released rather quickly. However, it's not uncommon for a movie to be filmed quickly and then be released within a year of production wrapping. Basically, this new director shared on the official Jeepers Creepers Reborn YouTube page some of the struggles and obstacles of shooting the film during the COVID pandemic. He's from Finland, and he mentioned that being restricted from traveling and seeing his family made things very hard for him while working on Jeepers Creepers Reborn. One thing I do want to mention is this director does not like talking about this movie at all. Like, people keep asking him about it on his Instagram, and he's legit out, flat out, starting to say, "Hey, shut the fuck up!" Let's get more back into the new information of this movie. He basically had said that one of his major priorities while shooting was to make sure that everyone was happy and healthy on set, and he really believed that he achieved this because there was no infections while filming this movie, which is a good sign. Now, there's been no official release for Jeepers Creepers Reborn, and there actually hasn't been a cast that has been released for this movie. Who knows when this movie is actually going to come out? But despite it coming out, despite them talking about this movie maybe coming out in a few months, and it's already being filmed, they literally have not made an official cast announcement or nothing. As of this video, the official Jeepers Creepers Reborn IMDb page only exists as one actor, Gabriel something. I can't remember how to pronounce the last name, but he's basically going to be playing a character named Sam. Now, I don't think there's like a big secret surrounding the cast. You know, it's just probably something the production team hasn't gotten around to yet. Another thing that we should mention is the Jeepers Creepers Reborn film will be scarier than the previous films. When speaking to Verity about Jeepers Creepers Reborn, Screen Media's creative executive producer or executive Connor McAdams had this to say with the upcoming horror film. "As excited as we are, we know that fans will be even more thrilled and chilled to return to the world of the Creeper, now with a much scarier vision from director, blah blah blah, can't say his name, who's the perfect fit to restart this franchise. The first Jeepers Creepers was definitely terrifying at the time, so we're excited to see how this new director makes the Creeper even more frightening." Now, we gotta talk about this new Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie, because there are some new details coming to the surface that got a lot of fans worried about this movie. Now, the latest installment in the long-running horror franchise, the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, is now going to officially release on Netflix. That is right, they're going to be dropping this movie straight to Netflix. Now, since making its debut in 1974, Tobe Hooper's horrific tale of a backwoods family of murderous cannibals has both frightened and repulsed audiences around the world. It's been literally banned and censored in numerous countries upon its release, and today the film is seen as a big benchmark in horror movie making history. It really continues to inspire both aspiring and established filmmakers, and it's moved beyond films into a wide range of media. Now, one of the things that makes the homicidal killer Leatherface a big popular killer is because of his sheer brutality, but it's also a part of the mask that's made of human skin that covers his face. And to date, this franchise has delivered 8 different films with a 9th on its way this year. And though Tobe Hooper passed in 2017, he only returned to direct one other Texas Chainsaw film after his work on the original its 1986 sequel, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2. Aside from this, the celebrated filmmaker's only other connection to the franchise was really just as a producer for the 2003 remake. Now, basically, this new film is now, like I said, getting released on Netflix. As a report from THR, it now looks like this Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie is going to be coming to Netflix. It's 100% confirmed. This time around, the film is expected to pick up right where Hooper left off in 1974, bringing audiences to a point in which the terrors of Leatherface haven't been known for quite some time. There's going to be a lot of new audience members that are going to be joining this movie. It's something that we got to keep in mind. So they are going to be doing some backstory explaining. So don't get mad at that, guys. A new backstory explanation, something that we can get through. If it's 15 minutes, 20 minutes, whatever, I can get through that. Now, along with this character's return, fans can also undoubtedly expect much of the same violence and mayhem that the past entries have provided to us. This film is going to definitely be bloody. It's definitely going to be gory and all of that. Now, I do want to mention the reason why a lot of people are just skeptical about this movie is it's because Netflix is buying this movie. And I gotta say, Netflix is, what's the word for it? Netflix is, you know, popularity rating for bringing good movies onto their platform has kind of been dwindled, I guess, in the past now. They just buy any movie, really. Like, they buy some of the worst films to ever be made. So I don't understand, you know, why they would bring it to Netflix and act like, you know, holy shit, it's coming to Netflix. It's going to be an amazing movie. Off anything, people are going to be worried about if this movie's going to be good. If this movie is not good enough to come in theaters, how good is it really going to be? Now, as of this video, there's no official release date for this new Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie. Now, I don't know if that's whether just because they're trying to build more hype about this movie, get people more intrigued about it. I don't think that's a good marketing technique at all, because a lot of people don't even know that there's a new Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie in the works because of the lack of marketing and promotions towards this film. But who knows, there could be a lot of things going on behind the scenes that we currently don't know about because no news has been brought up about it. But I do think that you guys should still have some hype for this film. You guys should still be excited because this movie is being made by the director of Evil Dead, Fed Alvarez, the remake. Now, the reason why I say you guys should definitely be hyped for this is just because the remake for Evil Dead, although it didn't feel anything like the original Evil Dead, it felt more like a new story, a fresh idea, and it was definitely creepy and scary. And if he is behind this movie, I definitely have faith that this movie may come out, like, you know, pretty decent. I know Evil Dead is definitely not a slasher film, but you've seen the chainsaw scene at the end of that movie. Come on. That movie, that director, he could come up with something pretty good for a Netflix horror film. But that is all the information that we do have about this new Texas Chainsaw Massacre. You know me, your boy's going to start making all the videos about it when a lot of marketing and stuff comes out. Because we have only gotten one marketing promotion for this movie, which is a poster on a website that got released way back in October of last year. So they can start releasing this shit to us anytime. Come on, give me some chainsaws. Now let's talk about some Terrifier 2. So if you guys don't know, eons and eons ago, we actually got a trailer for Terrifier 2, and I will say that this movie does also still look a little low budgety. If you guys don't know, the first Terrifier 2 movie is obviously very low budget, but the thing that people liked about Terrifier was that the gore, the way the kills were done, very unique kills, very amazing. And if you're a true horror fan, you will appreciate movies just for the slasher value of it. A lot of people try to hate on Terrifier 2, but then they also try to say that Killer Clowns from Outer Space is a fantastic movie. Like, we all know that movie is B-rated. B-rated movies have value to it. B-rated horror movies are good at times. There's a lot of ones that are just crash and burn, they're horrible, let's not talk about them. But there are a lot of B-rated movies that are freaking amazing. There's a lot of B-rated movies that are now horror movies that are talked about so proudly that people, you wouldn't even know it's a B-rated movie until you actually watched it. Now with Terrifier 2, again, they released this trailer eons ago. They talked about a potential release date for October 21st. They just had to seal some sort of deal, and it is now close to October, and we've got no news on whether this movie is going to come out this October. We've got no promotion, no marketing, so I personally don't think this movie is going to get announced in October. I don't think they're going to release it in October. I think we're more looking at probably early 2022 or mid summer 2022 release. That's probably when we're going to get to see this movie. But let's get on to some of the new information that we have regarding this movie. So if you guys don't know, that there is an Indiegogo campaign trailer of some sort that landed online, and basically throughout that trailer they did show some footage for Terrifier 2. It's just some behind the scenes footage, it's nothing too spectacular, but I broke down some of the footage here to explain some of the stuff that is, you know, something that we should look at, some of the important behind the scenes. We're going to talk about some of the pictures here. So the first picture that popped up, you can see Elliot here in a classroom. Now they did talk about, a classroom scene that was going to be happening in this movie. Now there's a lot of talks about this other scene that could be taking place in this movie, which is some sort of like party. It could be like a rave or some sort of school celebration party. It's going to take place at nighttime, and I believe we'll see our character Victoria Hayes attending this party. Now we know Art the Clown is going to show up at this party. It's just a given fact. What are we going to see at this party? Are we going to see Art the Clown go into a room and just start killing a bunch of people? That's something that I would like to see. I had gotten this idea from a horror creator that I watch called Killjoy Jake. You guys should definitely go and check out his videos. But I was just thinking the same thing, and then he just took the words out of my mouth, and he was like, what if they like go into the, like, you know, they just have like a killer go in the room and start slashing off everybody? I said, that's brilliant. That's exactly what I'm thinking. So make sure you guys go follow Killjoy Jake. He's a fantastic horror creator. Now, I know that's not the biggest Terrifier 2 update, but rest assured, pretty soon we're going to have a lot of updates to discuss on the channel. So if you guys don't know, this weekend they're going to be doing a Texas Frightmare Weekend. This is going to be happening in Texas, of course, and it's going to be happening at Saturday at 5 p.m. And they're going to be doing this Terrifier panel with director Damian Leon and David Howard Thornton, and they're going to be giving us a 4-minute exclusive footage for Terrifier 2. We're going to be getting a 4-minute scene of this movie. Now, what can we expect in this scene? Let's discuss it. An important detail that you guys got to keep in mind is the director did say that there is going to be a kill in this movie that completely tops off the kill we seen in the first Terrifier movie, where we see Art the Clown completely slicing up this woman upside down, completely in half. That was amazing. That is a gore scene in a slasher film that it's in my top 10, 100%. I don't know what they can do to top that kill, but I know they can do something. I don't think that they're going to show that kill in this 4-minute clip. That is something that he's talking so greatly about it. I think he wants to save that for us fans to actually see when we watch the movie. But you already know what scene I'm talking about with this first movie. If they can top that scene, oh my god, the slasher in me, I'm getting goosebumps, y'all. I'm getting fucking goosebumps. Now again, we're gonna see Victoria Hayes return in this Terrifier 2 movie, and they're really setting this girl up to be a survivor girl within the Terrifier world, and I just completely love that. I think that's brilliant, amazing to see. What do you guys think is gonna happen in this 4-minute clip? Do you think they're gonna show us a scene from the party? Do you think they're gonna show us a scene between our main survivor girl and Art the Clown? Do you think they're just gonna show us some sort of first kill? Or do you think we're actually gonna get a new trailer? Like, what do you guys think? I think if we're getting a 4-minute clip, we're probably not getting a trailer. We're probably actually getting a full-fledged scene. You already know we're gonna see Art the Clown kill somebody, but what I think is we're not gonna see this big hyped up scene that the director is talking about. We're most likely gonna see something around like the opening kill, maybe a scene where Art the Clown finally Victoria Hayes and Art the Clown's reappearance, like their get together when they first meet again. Who knows what we're gonna see, but we know that we are gonna see something. Now, another thing to keep in mind is we might not get to see this footage. This footage is being held at a event, so if you guys want to see this footage and you guys don't want to take the risk on that they might not release this footage on YouTube, like, we have no idea if somebody at this horror con is gonna actually like record footage and post it to YouTube, or whether they're actually gonna post this clip to YouTube themselves. So if you guys want to secure your chance to actually see this 4-minute clip, go over to Texas, get a ticket, and go check out this event. I'm definitely not doing that. I live all the way up in damn fucking Canada. It's gonna be cold up in here in a couple months. I'm definitely not going to damn Texas. I'm not going to Texas. But anyways, if you guys want to see that, all you guys really got to do is just go buy a ticket, or you guys can take the risk that they might not release it on YouTube. There's most likely going to be somebody that attends this event and tries their best to record the footage to post it on YouTube, but honestly, we're never going to know that until this actually happens. But it is confirmed that there is going to be a 4-minute clip for this Terrifier 2 movie that is going to be released at this horror con. Are you guys excited about this? Are you guys going to be attending this horror con? Do you guys live in Texas? If so, what do you guys think about this? If you're a big fan of Terrifier like I am, what do you guys think of this? Are you guys a big fan of these clown horror movies? Are you guys more just kind of like, eh, they're all right? Let me know all your thoughts and theories down below. That is all the information that we have to discuss today. I hope you guys did enjoy the first slasher flick. If you guys did enjoy it, make sure you guys comment that down below. Let me know what you think about all the different, you know, topics that we're talking about in one video. Do you guys like hearing about things separately and in their own separate videos? Or do you guys like hearing about some of these updates, you know, halfway, or all these updates spliced together into one big video? That's something that I want you guys to let me know in the comments down below. I'm most likely gonna do more slasher flicks. This is the slasher flick is more for like smaller updates, so we can splice those into one big enjoyable video. But we might, you know, just keep doing it for different things. It's just, sometimes there's videos that just deserve their own video, like a Scream 5 trailer update, big breakdowns. Those obviously deserve their own video. With all that being said, if you guys are new to the channel, make sure you guys do not hesitate to subscribe to the channel with post notifications turned on. Make sure you guys stab that like button right in the face. Follow me on Instagram and follow me on Twitter. Also, do not hesitate to join the Discord. I have a Discord channel. You can click the link in my bio. You're free to join. You join it up. We do Twitch streams. We watch movies every once in a while. So make sure you guys come and check that out. Slasher Theory Discord link is in my bio if you guys are interested in joining. But again, every like and subscription helps out a ton. I can keep making awesome horror content for you guys like this in the future. We got a couple new updates coming out tomorrow. I finally got a chance to see Don't Breathe 2. I just ended up saying screw it. I'm not going to the theaters. I watched it at home. It's a pretty good movie. I'm going to have my review up probably tomorrow, so make sure you guys come and check out the review for Don't Breathe 2. There's a lot of reviews out on YouTube, but if you guys want to hear my opinion, that'll be out tomorrow. Anyways, until next time, guys, make sure you guys douse a bucket of blood over your head just like Carrie, and make sure you guys stay bloody. Peace.